Friends, I am Vaibhav Srivastav from Vaibhav E-Learning Academy. Today, we are going to start a new topic in physics, that is circular motion. This is our part number 1. In today's video, we will be discussing about introduction to circular motion. Then, what are the angular terms like angular displacement, angular velocity and angular acceleration. So, these three terms we will be discussing in today's video. And then we'll be discussing about what actually is circular motion. So let us start. So what is circular motion? Circular motion basically means the motion of a particle in circular, in circle path. So if you take a particle P over here, it goes from one point to another point. That motion of the particle is called a circular motion. That is it, nothing else. So circular motion is one part of a type of motion called curvilinear motion. Circular motion is used in day-to-day life from everything, from a small atom to the earth and the sun. The atom revolves around the nucleus, that is also circular motion, and the earth revolves around the sun, that is also on circular motion. So let us start with the linear terms, the angular terms. First term is angular displacement, angular displacement. So here most of the terms will be from linear only. Linear in the sense normal displacement, normal velocity. Angular displacement and angular velocity are some different terms. So take a circle, for example, a circular path, a particle P, this is the center point O, this is the radius R. This move from this position to this position, P dash. This is the theta, angle made. This theta is called angular displacement. Angular displacement. What is angular displacement? For example, you keep the observer over here. There is a particle over here and it goes from this point to this point in some time t. So when the particles move from here to here, this position is called displacement, linear displacement. And if you are from the center, you will notice, for example, take the reference of an eye. You keep an eye here, from here to here the eye moves from this to this, from this angle to this angle. So the change in the angle, the change in the angle is called the displacement of the angle, which is angular displacement. From here, there is a particle P over here, it moves to here. This is a circular path, it moves here. From here to here, the shift in the angle is called the angular displacement. This angular displacement, it is a new term, so let us see about it. Is it a vector quantity or a scalar quantity? It is a vector quantity. Vector quantity. And it is an axial vector. What is axial vector? Vector which rotates about an axis. So point O, this is on axis. You will find the axial vector by using right hand thumb rule. Right hand thumb rule. So what you have to do is take your right hand. This is right hand. Check if the particle is moving in anti-clockwise or the clockwise direction. In this case, let the particle move from P to P dash in a clockwise direction. So you take your hand, curl it in clockwise direction, curl it in clockwise direction and see where it is, where your thumb is pointing. If you curl like this, your thumb is pointing outwards. So that outwards is the vector, that outwards is the direction of the O. That is the direction of the angular displacement. Similarly, if the point is moving from P to P dash down over here, you curl it like this and then the right hand goes inside. You curl like this, right hand is going inside. If it is going upside like this, it comes outside. This is the right hand thumb rule. This angular displacement, it has units in two form. First unit is measured in radian. Second, it is measured in theta or degree. we all know what is the difference between radians and degree. Here 2 pi radian is equals to 360 degree, pi radian is equals to 180 degree. Just these both we can remember on any one. Pi by 2 is equals to 90 degree, pi by 3 is equals to 60 degree, and so on. Pi by 6 is equals to 20 degree, and etc. So these are the units. It is measured in radian only. Mostly it is measured in radians. Degree, when we want to convert it, we convert it. Radian. So this angular displacement, it is a dimensionless quantity. Dimensionless quantity. It has no dimension. This is one very unique quantity. It has a unit, but it does not have any dimension. So this was angular displacement. How much you are moving your head from one part to another part, that is called the angular displacement. And this is the angular displacement. What is the linear displacement from point P to P dash? This S is the linear displacement. Now, is there any relation between S and theta? Let us find that out. So now we'll be finding the relation between linear displacement and angular displacement for one revolution. Okay, let us take this side theta, this side S. Here we have angular displacement, here you have linear displacement. If you are taking one full revolution, it means you are taking 360 degree, and 360 degree means 2 pi. This degree we are taking in radian. If you are taking 2 pi, then the displacement from one point to back to that point. Displacement is 0, but linear displacement is not 0. Linear displacement, you can compare it with distance. Linear displacement will be 2 pi r. The circumference of the circle. Okay. 2 pi radian gives 2 pi r. If you take 1 radian, then how much will you get? Take this quantity as x. 2 pi radian gives 2 pi r, 1 will give how much? You should do cross multiplication. 2 pi x gives you 2 pi r. 1 into 2 pi r, 2 pi r. 2 pi r, 2 pi r get cancelled, x is equals to r. Then here x is equals to r. So 2 pi radians gives 2 pi r as the displacement. Then 1 radian gives r as the displacement. Then if you are taking theta radians, it will give you theta r. Then S is equals to theta into r. Okay, let me explain again. 2 pi radian, if you are taking one full circumference, a particle from this point coming back to this point, angle made will be 360 degree, which is 2 pi radians, and the distance travelled by the particle is 2 pi radians. Okay. If the angle made is 1, from here to here you can take, then the distance travelled will be r. Similarly, if you take theta, angular displacement theta, then the displacement will be theta into r. The relation between angular displacement and linear displacement, S is equals to theta r. If you do not understand this equation, you can use one another method to find this out through a mathematical way. Theta is equals to arc length by radius. Here S is equals to theta r. So theta is equals to S by r. If you didn't understand this, one more method is there. For example, this is the same circle. This is point O. From here to here P, it comes to here P dash. This is theta and this is S. This is the radius. So theta is equals to arc length by radius. Here what is the arc? S is the arc. So S by r. Theta is equals to S by r. There are two ways to derive the same thing. Here S is equals to r theta. Theta is equals to S by r. You can derive it either in this way or this way. The formula is S is equals to theta into r. The relation between linear displacement and angular displacement is S is equals to r into theta. This is the angular displacement. Now, the second term is angular velocity. So, the second quantity is the angular velocity. Now let us see what is this. Here, again here, same circle, point O, radius, and here, particle P. Now, in time t1, let us assume the particle is over here, p1 at time t1. Okay. This is the point. This angle is theta 1. Okay. Then in time t2, the particle reaches somewhere over here. P2 t2. The position of the particle is 2. It is over here. This is theta 2 and this is delta theta. Now, what is delta theta? It is the change in angular displacement. It is theta 2 minus theta 1. This angular displacement, in final angular displacement, what is initial angular displacement? Delta t is the final time minus initial time. If you remember, linear velocity is equals to change in displacement by change in time. Similarly, angular velocity, which is omega, is equals to change in angular displacement by time. This is the formula. W is equals to, you can say theta by t. W is equals to theta by t, you can say mostly. Here, if you want to find average angular velocity, then it will be delta theta upon delta t. So average is equals to theta 2 minus theta 1 by t2 minus t1, which is equals to delta theta by delta t. This is the average. And if you want to find instantaneous angular velocity, then time t tends to 0, you can say d theta by dt. D theta is for very small, the change is very small, then you can say it is D, and delta when the change is very big. This is the average angular velocity, this is the instant angular velocity. This is also a new term. So for this angular velocity omega, its unit is like theta by t. Theta is radian, by time is second, so you can say radian per second. The unit is radian per second. Dimension, radian has no dimension, but s, it is 1 by t, so it is L0 e to the power minus 1. It is also a vector quantity, it is also an axial vector. You can even measure this by using the right hand thumb rule. If the velocity from here to here, then you have to rotate like this, it is outside. So similarly, this is the angular displacement, angular velocity of the particle from point P2. This is the angular velocity. So here, these all are the things regarding angular velocity. Now, if you want to take a deep view about what is this angular velocity, you have to understand another concept in angular velocity over here. So this is the same thing, particle P over here, okay? This thing right here is, okay, P. Now this particle P, it is moving with some velocity, okay? This velocity V, this is the radius, okay? After some time, the velocity reaches here. It is again moving in this direction, the radius is still R. Now the particle came over here, it is moving with V, the radius is still R, and the velocity came here, it is moving with V, the radius is R. So you can say that velocity and radius can be perpendicular. Velocity is perpendicular to radius. Here we are talking about like linear velocity, like angular velocity, it is perpendicular to the radius. This is one more point regarding this angular velocity. Now let us see one question regarding the angular velocity. One question with angular velocity we will see. So let us see the question. So now we have one question over here. if theta is equals to 2 t square plus 2, then find omega in 2s and add 2s. So here in 2 second and add 2 second, they are 2. So in 2 second and add 2 second. In 2 second means we have to find the average from 0 to 2 second. First part in 2 second. So 0 to 2 second. Add 2 second is at that instant we have to find. So first one is average. Omega average is equals to delta theta by delta t. Delta theta 2 t square plus 2. So here it is delta, so we can substitute t is equals to 2. Delta theta is equals to theta 2 minus theta 1 by t. Delta t is equals to change in time, here time given is equals to 2 seconds, or else let it take t2 minus t1. Theta 2, so theta 2 in the sense, first it is in 2 second, then at 0 second. So first in theta 2 substitute t is equals to 2, theta 1 substitute t is equals to 0. So 2 into 2 square plus 1, plus 2 minus, this is the theta 2 value, 0, 2 into 0 square plus 2, let me write this down, which is equals to 2 into 2 square plus 2 theta 2 minus 2 into 0 square plus 2 by t2 minus t1, t2 is 2 minus t1 is 0. So you will get 2 square 4, 4 2 is 8 plus 2 is equals to 10 minus 0, 2 into 0, 0 square is 0, 2 into 0, 0 plus 2 by 2, which is 8 minus 2, which is equals to 4. Average rate, so 4 radian per second. This is the average angular velocity for this. The second one we have to find at 2 seconds. So t tends to 2 seconds. Okay. So d theta by dt. Here we have to use differentiation d by dt of 2t plus 2. Differentiation of constant is 0. 2t gives you 2 radian per second. This is the answer for the second question. T tends to 2 second. D theta by dt. D into theta is 2t square plus 2. So 2 radian per second. Because differentiation of constant is 0 and d of 2t with respect to dt. So this will be t to the power 1 minus 1. So t to the power 0, which is equals to 1. So 2. So this is the answer for the question. Omega average is equals to delta theta by delta t. So theta 2 minus theta 1 by d2 minus t1. Here this theta 2 we substituted t is equals to 2 seconds and theta 1 we substituted t is equals to 0 second. And we got the answer as 4 radian per second. And the second question we differentiated with 2 radian per second. So this is the question. Now, like displacement, we found the relation between angular displacement and linear displacement. Is there any relation between angular velocity and linear velocity? Let us see that. So if you are taking velocity, you will get ds by dt, displacement by time, right? Differentiation of displacement with respect to time. If you want to find ds, you will get v dt. How will you find s? Then you will integrate ds, which is equals to integration on v dt. Integration on both sides. Integration of ds is equals to s. S is equals to integration of v dt. Similarly, here omega is equals to d theta by dt. If you want to find theta, then d theta is equals to omega dt. Integrate on both sides. Omega d theta is equals to omega dt with integration. This will become theta is equals to integration of omega dt. So the operations which we apply on linear variables and angular variables are same. S is equals to integration of v dt and theta is equals to integration of omega dt. Now omega is equals to delta theta by delta t. We all know delta theta is equals to delta s by r. We found out, right, that s is equals to r theta, then theta is equals to s by r. Same thing you can take s by r over here. Okay, s by r by delta t. Here you take change in only, because we are talking about change in every quantity. So change in displacement by radius. Radius is always constant. For any circle, the radius won't change. So you can take radius outside. Delta theta is equal to radius, not radius, because it is delta s by r, 1 by r into delta s by delta t. Delta theta is equal to 1 by r into delta s by delta t. This is velocity. What velocity? Linear velocity. So v. So delta theta is equals to everything. Why it is theta? Delta omega, actually, sorry. Everywhere it should be omega, not theta. Because you are finding the angular velocity here. So delta omega is equals to delta theta by delta t. Delta theta is delta s by r. Radius will take outside because it is constant. So 1 by r into delta s by delta t. Delta s by delta t is velocity, so 1 by r into v. So omega, delta omega is equals to v by r. This is the relationship between angular velocity and linear velocity. V is equals to r omega. V is equals to r omega. Similarly, s is equals to r theta. Velocity is equals to radius into angular velocity. Displacement is equal to radius into angular displacement. So by r. So one thing, omega is equal to v by r. This is applicable only for circles. How? Let us see. Omega is equal to v by r. This is applicable only for circles. For other cases, other than circle, omega is equal to v perpendicular by r. This will work in every case. In every case. Previously, when I draw this diagram, like particle from here, it goes with v velocity. The radius is r, 0.0. This is the radius. From here, the particle came here, the velocity is v, the radius is still r. Here also, radius is r, velocity like this. So always velocity is perpendicular to radius in circle only. In the case of circle only, velocity is always perpendicular to the radius. So omega is equals to v by r. This case is valid for circles. But in other cases, omega is equals to v perpendicular by r. This formula we have to use. Now, v perpendicular, what is the meaning of v perpendicular? V perpendicular means component of velocity perpendicular to omega. Okay? Perpendicular to the radius. Okay, component of velocity perpendicular to the radius, that is v perpendicular. Now we will take one question about angular velocity, but not in circles. So let us see how will we solve those kinds of questions. So this is our question. Here we have to find omega of b when observed from a. So omega is equals to v perpendicular by r. Here radius from a to b is 3 meter, so r is equals to 3. V perpendicular, so here we should not put 20 meter per second, we have to take the perpendicular value, the value of v which is perpendicular with a. So this is the point A, this is the point B, and that is 20 meter per second. Here it is 37 degrees. So this is the horizontal component and this is the vertical component. From A, this is the perpendicular. So this will be 20 into cos 37. This will be 20 into sin 37. This one, 20 sin 37 degree. Sin 37 degree triangle, this one, here 3, here 4 and here 5. So sin 37 degree, 20 into sin 37. So 20 into sin 37 is 3 by 5 by 3. 5 ones are 5, 4s are 4, 3s are 12 by 3. This is equals to 4 radian per second. This is the angular velocity. V perpendicular by R. This is valid for every cases. And omega is equals to, we can put V by R directly in the cases of circles. This was the question. Now after these many terms, we have some more terms which are non-angular. We still have angular velocity, but that we will be discussing later in this video. So the next term is frequency. What is frequency? Frequency. What is frequency? So here the number of revolutions per second is called frequency. This is the unit, I mean this is the how you measure, this is the symbol, frequency symbol, this is nu. You can also say it as N or also you can say it as F. So nu is the most commonly used, this is nu. So frequency, in angle, this formula we have to remember that angular displacement is equals to 2 pi nu. So it means that in 1 second, if there is one revolution, then the frequency is 1. In 1 second, if there is 2 revolution, then the frequency is 2. Similarly, in 1 second, if there is 2 pi revolutions, then it is 2 pi into nu. That is why theta is equals to 2 pi into nu. If we want to find omega with respect to frequency, omega is equals to delta theta upon delta t. Delta theta is what? 2 pi nu by delta t. Delta t, it means that the number of revolution per second. So it will be 1 only. So omega is also equals to 2 pi nu. This is the relation between 2 pi nu. This is the relation between frequency and angular displacement. This is the frequency and angular velocity, frequency and angular displacement. Both are same because the time period is 1 second. This is the frequency. After frequency, the next quantity we have time period. What is time period? What is time period? The time required for one complete revolution is called the time period. So in 1 second there is one revolution, then the time period is like 1 second. So similarly, if you are taking nu is equals to nu, like nu is equals to nu, then you will take t is equals to 1 by nu. This is the relationship between time and frequency. The time is equals to 1 by frequency. In 1 second there is 1 revolution, then in 1 second there is 2 revolution, then it means that 1 nu, 2 nu. Similarly, the formula which we get, time is equals to 1 by nu. This is the formula for time period. Now let us see one question regarding frequency and time period. Let us see. So this is our question. What is the angular velocity in radian per second of a flywheel making 300 rotations per minute? So first of all, If you want to find in radian per second, convert this RPM into RPS. So nu is equals to 300 into 1 by 60 rounds per second. 00615. So nu is equals to 5 rounds per second. We have to convert round per minute to round per second. What is the angular velocity? Omega is equals to 2 pi nu. This is the relationship between omega and nu. Omega is equals to 2 into pi value 3.14 into. What is the value for nu? Nu is 5. So omega is equals to 2 5s are 10 into 3.14. Omega is equals to 31.4 radian per second. This is the question. This kind of question will only come for the angular velocity and frequency relationship. What is the angular velocity for a flywheel making 300 RPM? Omega is equals to 5 round per second. Convert the RPM into RPS and then we use the relationship between omega and frequency. So this was everything about angular displacement, angular velocity. Now let us move on to the accelerations. The accelerations involved in a circular motion. Accelerations. There are four types of accelerations involved in a circular motion. First type is centripetal acceleration. Second type is tangential acceleration. Third type is net acceleration. And the fourth type is angular acceleration. These are the four types of accelerations which are involved for any particle moving in a circular motion. So, centripetal acceleration, this is represented by AC, tangential acceleration by AT, net acceleration by AN, and angular acceleration by alpha. These are the four types of accelerations involved when a particle is rotating in a circular path or circular track. First one is centripetal acceleration. What is centripetal acceleration? There is any particle which is moving like this with velocity v. There is always an acceleration which pulls it towards the center point O. This is acceleration of centripetal acceleration. Similarly, from here to here also, the velocity v came this side. Then acceleration, centripetal acceleration is always towards the center, any particle which is moving. Here we have to note one very important point. Centripetal acceleration. Centripetal acceleration is present always in circular motion. In circular motion, always centripetal acceleration is present. How? Because whenever circular motion means any particle moving inside a circle. If any particle is moving in circle, there is something which is allowing it to be in its path. For example, when the earth is revolving around the sun, the gravitation force becomes as centripetal force. When the electron is revolving around the nucleus, the electrostatic force becomes centripetal force. So here, acceleration, centripetal acceleration is always present whenever a particle is moving. So, one point we have to remember that velocity is present. Okay. It may be uniform or non-uniform. The magnitude may be constant. Magnitude may be constant, but direction always changes. direction always changes. If it is not changing, then it is not circular motion, then it is a linear motion. But velocity is always constantly changing, it keeps on changing. Magnitude may be constant, like here 5 meter per second, here 5, here 5, here 5. But the direction is changing. Here the direction is upwards, here the direction is left side, here the direction is down, and here the direction is again the right side. So the direction keeps on changing, but the magnitude is always constant. This is centripetal acceleration. The formula for centripetal acceleration, AC is equals to V square by R. And for centripetal force, it is MV square by R. Centripetal acceleration is equals to V square by R. This is the formula for centripetal acceleration. Any acceleration which is pulling it towards the center, that is why it is rotating. Actually, if the acceleration is pulling it towards this side, then why is it going in this direction? This we will learn in net acceleration. So, second type is tangential acceleration. AT. Second type, tangential acceleration. Same, there is a particle over here. Now here we have two cases, so let us draw two circles. Case 1 and case 2. Here first case, velocity is increasing, and second case, velocity is decreasing. These are the two cases, velocity is increasing and velocity is decreasing. Here this is the point O. Always centripetal acceleration is acting on the particle. Particle P moving here. What is the force which is allowing the particle to move? That is tangential acceleration. That acceleration, if the velocity is increasing, then the acceleration is also acting towards that side. If the velocity is decreasing, then the acceleration is acting opposite. This is the tangential acceleration. Always notice one thing, tangential acceleration is here, centripetal is here, the angle is 90 degree. Here also, tangential acceleration downwards, acceleration centripetal this side, here also 90 degree. So, tangential acceleration is always perpendicular to centripetal acceleration. This is the tangential acceleration. The force which is allowing the particle to move in the upwards direction is tangential acceleration. Tangential acceleration, AT is equals to D into magnitude of velocity by DT. This is an important point. Tangential acceleration does not care whether the velocity is going upwards or downwards or left or right. It is only dependent on the magnitude of the direction. Mod V. So velocity, this is velocity V. But mod of V is equals to speed. So you can say ds by dt, but s will be confused with displacement. That is why d mod V by dt. This is the tangential acceleration formula. This is second term, which is tangential acceleration. Now, third one, we have the net acceleration. Now, what is net? Net means total. Third one, net acceleration. So, here the tangential acceleration is acting like this, centripetal acceleration is acting like this, then the resultant will be like this, okay? Tangential acceleration like this, centripetal like this, then the net is like this. This is AT, this is AC, this is a net. This acceleration depends upon both magnitude and direction. See this one, let me write it. A net is equals to, you can say AT plus AC, I cap, J cap, whatever you want you can put. So A net total is equals to under root of AT square plus AC square. Here, what is A net? So for example, this is the tangential acceleration, this is the centripetal. Here we are taking the particle is this side tangential, here centripetal is this. Because of vector, you see that the net acceleration is like this, a net. Okay. So this has dependence both on magnitude and direction. Direction, because which side is it going to run? See, if tangential is acting upside, centripetal is acting this side, how is the particle moving in this side? It is because of net acceleration. If you take a stone tight with the thread and then rotate it, the tangential acceleration is acting outside. How will you find the tangential acceleration? If you take a stone tight with any string and if you rotate it, for example, while rotating, particle is at here and I cut this stone, the particle will fly that side. So tangential acceleration is acting that side. Similar, if I keep on rotating at point here, at this point if I cut the string, the particle will fly that side. Tangential acceleration is that side. And tangential acceleration, in most of the cases, it is greater than the centripetal acceleration. A net is equals to under root of at square plus ac square, or you can also say a net is equals to dv by dt whole mod dv by dt, because it has dependence on both magnitude and direction. This is the net acceleration. These three are one of the more important one, and then we have the angular acceleration, that is most important. Before moving on, let us solve one question regarding this accelerations. Let us see. So our question is, if v is equals to 2t, radius is equals to 9 meter, find centripetal acceleration, tangential acceleration, net acceleration at t is equals to 3 seconds. First one, centripetal acceleration. It is v square by r. Okay. Radius is 9 meter, v square, v is equals to 2t and t given 3 seconds. So 2 into 3, which is equals to 6. So v square by r, here it is 6 square. 6 square by r is 9. So 6 square is 36 by 9, which is equals to 4. 4 meter per second square. This is the acceleration centripetal. Second one is tangential acceleration. It is equals to d mod of v by dt. So what is v? V given 2t. So d by dt of 2t. It is equals to 2 meter per second square. Differentiation of 2t is equals to 2t to the power 1 minus 1. So t to the power 0, 2 into 1 is equals to 2, so 2 meter per second square. Third question, net acceleration. It is equals to under root of ac square plus at square. Under root of ac square, 4 meter per second whole square, 16, plus at square, 2 whole square, 4. Under root of 20, which is equals to under root of 4 into 5, which is equals to 2 root 5 meter per second square. Now, this is net acceleration. If you want to find the direction, for example, this is tangential acceleration, this is centripetal, this is the net acceleration. If you want to find with this, with tangential acceleration, what is the direction? So tan beta or tan alpha is equals to, this AC will come upside because it is parallel shifting of vectors, it becomes triangle law. Then you will get AC by AT. So if you want to find the direction of this, then you will get tan alpha is equals to AC by AT. AC is 4 by AT is 2. So tan alpha is equals to 2. Alpha is equals to tan inverse 2 with respect to tangential acceleration. This is how you will find. Now, what if velocity, it is given a constant, let's say 6 meter per second. So, if velocity given constant, then if you find AC, AT and A net, what will be the answer? So, if velocity is constant, AC is equals to V square by R. Constant is 6. So, 6 square by 9, you will get 36 by 9, which is equals to 4. Okay. Second question, AT. AT is equals to d mod v by dt. Now, v is a constant. Differentiation of constant is 0. So, AT is equals to 0. third question, net acceleration, it is equals to under root of ac square plus at square. At square is 0, so it is equals to under root of ac square. Root and square gets cancelled, so it is equals to ac. So net acceleration is equals to centripetal acceleration, which is equals to 4 meter per second square. So if the velocity is constant, then the net acceleration is equals to the centripetal acceleration and tangential acceleration is 0. This is the question. Now let us move on to angular acceleration. This is angular acceleration, the main acceleration. So now we have angular acceleration. The formula for angular acceleration, alpha is equals to delta omega upon delta t. So normal acceleration is equals to dv by dt, or you can say delta v by delta t. So here we are talking about angular acceleration. So it is delta of angular velocity, delta omega by delta t. This is the formula for angular acceleration. Now if we know the relations, that is here s, here if you take theta, here there is s. Angular displacement, linear displacement, the relation is s is equals to r theta. Okay. Here omega, angular velocity. Here v, linear velocity. Relation is v is equals to r omega. Okay. Here angular acceleration, here linear acceleration, then acceleration is equals to r into alpha. Is this correct? Because this one is correct and this one is correct, but a is equals to r alpha. This, if you write this statement, then it is wrong. A is equals to r alpha. Here a is which type of acceleration? Tangential acceleration or centripetal acceleration or net acceleration? Here a is tangential acceleration. Then we should write a t is equals to r alpha. This is the angular acceleration. Angular acceleration, you can say omega 2 minus omega 1 by t2 minus t1. Simple logic, delta omega by delta 3. This is the angular acceleration. So these are all the concepts, and we have one last question regarding angular acceleration. Let us see that question and we'll end the session. So let us see. So our question is, a particle travels a circle of radius 20 cm at a speed that increases uniformly. If the speed changes from 5 meter per second to 6 meter per second in 2 seconds, find alpha. We have to find alpha. So formula is tangential acceleration is equals to radius into alpha. So alpha is equals to tangential acceleration by radius. So here we have to find tangential acceleration first. At is equals to dv by dt, but here as they have given the value from 5 to 6, we can take delta d by delta t, delta v by delta t. Okay, tangential acceleration is d mod v by t. Here you can take mod also, it is 6 minus 1, you will get 5. So here v2 minus v1 by t2 minus t1. V2 minus V1 is 6 minus 5, which is 1, by T2 minus T1, 2, which is equals to 0.5 meter per second square. This is the tangential acceleration. Now, alpha is equals to tangential acceleration by radius. 0.5 meter per second square by radius is 20 centimeter. Convert this centimeter into meter, so you will get 0.5 by 0.2, which is 2.5 meter per second square. This is the angular acceleration. Here alpha is equals to, we have to find tangential acceleration is equals to r into alpha. Angular acceleration is equals to tangential acceleration by radius. So tangential acceleration is v2 minus v1 by t2 minus t1. So 6 minus 5 is 1 by 2, 0.5. 0.5 by radius is 20 centimeter, converted into meter. So we got 2.5 meter per second square. that is it for today's video. I hope you have enjoyed today's video. We have learned about angular variables and some questions regarding acceleration. So we'll see you in the next video. If you like this video, do like it. Share to your friends if you found it informative. Subscribe to this channel if you're new. See you next time. Thank you and goodbye.